Hello everyone, in this part 2 of probability, we are going to discuss few questions related to probability. In last video, I had explained about the some important points related to probability. One of them is sample space, and also I had explained about mutually exclusive events and mutually exhaustive events. Today we are going to do few questions related to sample space and mutually exhaustive events. Let's start with the question number 1A part. A box contains one red and three identical white balls. Two balls are drawn at random in succession with replacement. Write the sample space for this experiment. First of all, we have the identical white balls. That means for white balls, we can take the simple notation W, and for red ball, we can take the notation R. On the basis of this, we can say that the sample space for this one will be red, white, white, red, 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 white, white. This will be the sample space for this part for question number 1A. Part. Now, question number 1B part. A person is noting down the number of accidents along a busy highway during a year. Write the sample space for this experiment. Look at this thing. If first day man is observing, let the number of accidents will be 0. Second day it may be 1. Third day it may be 2. So on the basis of this, we can say that the sample space for this one will be 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on. This will be the sign for this part and so on. It means the number of accidents during the day may be varied. Now, question number 1C part. An experiment consists of tossing a coin and then tossing it second time if a head occurs. If a tails occurs on first toss, then a dice is rolled once. Find the sample space. So for this part, look at this thing. If tails is coming, then we have to roll or we have to toss coin again. So sample space will be TH, TT. But if head is coming, then he is rolling a dice. It means what will be here? H1, H2, H3, H4, H5, H6. This will be the sample space for this part when he is using this concept. Now look at this thing, D part. In this D part, consider the experiment in which a coin is tossed repeatedly until a head comes up. Describe the sample space. Look at this thing. Till then, head is not coming, our experiment is not over. Supposing first attempt head is coming, it is not the meaning that experiment is over. It may be the chance that in first attempt tail is coming, again he is tossing, tail is coming, then again head is coming, or it may be happened that four times he is tossing, tail coming, and next time head is coming. So for this part, we can say that the sample space will be H, TH, TTH, TT, TH, and so on. And this will be the curly bracket. It means this is the part for the sample space. Now look at this thing. In E part, they are saying two dice are thrown and the sum of the numbers which comes up on the dice is noted. When two dice are rolled, then total sample space or total outcomes will be 36. But they are saying for this we have to find out the or we have to check the sum of the numbers which comes up on the dice. So sum of the numbers, that's why the sample space will be 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So this will be the sample space for this part. Now what they are saying, A is the event that the sum is even. So A is the event the sum is even means 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. This is for A. Now the B, event B is the sum is a multiple of 3. It means 3, 6, 9, 12. Sum is the multiple of 3. C is the event, the sum is less than 4. Less than 4 means 2, 3. And D is the event that the sum is greater than 11. It means this is 12 only. Now what they are saying, we have to check which pair of these events are mutually exclusive. If we will check for A intersection B, then this is not equals to 5. If we will check A intersection C, then this is also not equals to 5. If we will check A intersection D, then this is also not equals to 5. Now come to this point, B intersection C. B intersection is also not equals to 5. B intersection D is also not equals to 5. Then come to C intersection D. C intersection D is 5. Therefore, we can say C and D are mutually exclusive events. C and D are mutually exclusive events. So in this way, we have to try to solve the other questions. Don't forget to give the answer of this question in comment box. Thanks and God bless you.